What's up, guys? Before we get today's episode rolling, I just wanted to announce that our good friends at DeWitt's Radiator just provided me with a promo code for you guys. So any of my viewers, if you use the promo code MyCorvetteLife, all one word, I'm going to put it up on the screen here, MyCorvetteLife, use that code at checkout and get yourself 10% off your entire order on DeWitt's website. So if you guys have been thinking that, hey, that DeWitt's radiator is a little bit spendy, can't really afford it now. I mean, 10% off, that is a big chunk of change on a $700 radiator. So if you guys are in the market for a DeWitt's radiator, now is the time. 10% off, my Corvette life. Go check it out. What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to my Corvette life. So the C4 is finally done. I just finished putting the interior parts back together last night. The new dash cap went on pretty easily. Didn't make a video about that because honestly, the video probably would have been like 1 minute long. Really wasn't worth it. It's pretty straightforward to put it together. So got that back together. So the car is done now. So today we're going to take it for a drive and I'm going to give you guys a little bit of feedback on some of the changes that I've noticed as far as the suspension and some other things. So let's go ahead and fire it up and get going. All right, so we're just getting going. Gonna get the car up to temperature a little bit. We're gonna take it for about a 30-minute drive, and I'm gonna point out a few things. First of all, you'll notice that there are no warning lights on anymore. I did have a door ajar light on, and since I replaced the door ajar switches, that went away, so that's awesome. No warning lights whatsoever. So a few people have asked me if the air conditioner works in this car, and yes, it works actually really well. And see, I've got it on right there. Windows are rolled up and I'm cruising, and it's very comfortable in here, and it's like 115 degrees today. Also happy to report that the differential is not leaking anymore since I resealed it, so got that going for me. This car, for having 140,000 miles, has zero leaks at all. This car is mechanically in excellent condition. You might remember when I first bought the car, it had a huge power steering leak. I fixed that, I fixed the differential leak, and there's no other leaks now. So knock on wood, this car is doing real well. So when I bought the car, the previous owner thought that there might be an issue with the transmission because the car was having a weird vibration at speed. And when I purchased the car, I diagnosed that vibration to be the U-joints. And I can confirm after replacing all of the U-joints in this car that that vibration is 100% gone. I can also confirm after doing the transmission fluid drain and fill, and as well as doing the transmission filter, that the shifts are buttery smooth, a lot better than they were, although they weren't terrible before, but it's definitely noticeably different. Now let's talk about those new shocks. Definitely a lot better. A lot of people I've read have complained that the Bilsteins are very harsh, and I just don't feel that. I mean, this car is very cushy with the new shocks. The old shocks I didn't think were that bad, but these ones are even better. AC on, cruising at 65 miles an hour, coolant temp is 210, oil pressure 62, and it's 115 degrees Fahrenheit outside. That is not bad. This car has the stock radiator and everything. There's nothing special about it. That just goes to tell you, if you have a clean cooling system and it's working as intended, you're not going to experience those super high
about that.
Stop and go traffic, but at this point, I don't even think the fans are on at this temperature. So I've been sitting here in my driveway with the AC on, car running for probably 15 minutes now, and temperature is only 223. So I'm gonna call that a win.
So that's it. The car is officially listed for sale. I will put the link in the description below. If you are interested, go check it out. However, by the time this video airs, I have no idea if the car will be sold already or not. It's possible that it is, because this video is lagging a few days behind from when it actually went up for sale. But if it's not, go ahead and check it out. Send me an email. My email is also in the description below, and we'll work something out. So to whoever buys this car, I really wish you guys the best of adventures. Drive the heck out of it. That's what this thing is made for. Go on adventures and have a great time, because we only live once, and you gotta do it. You gotta do it. Everybody should buy a Corvette at least once in their life. You don't have to go out and spend $100,000 on a new one. These ones are very inexpensive, and honestly, they're cheaper than most Honda Civics out there. So go pick one up and have a good time. Anyways, that is going to do it for today's video. I do have one more video for sure that I'm gonna do with this car. My wife is going to be driving it. So she's wanted to drive it since I bought it about a year ago. The car's finally done, so she has the opportunity to drive it before it goes to its new owner. So that should be a good video, so stay tuned. That'll be coming up next. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.